Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Sampurasun and hello nice people there. Welcome back to our UniTalk program. And for today episode, for this episode, UniTalk will be having a nice interview with a special guest. He is actually from the United Kingdom or the UK. Don't you know him? He's the first person here in Indonesia, you know? Because actually, who is he? He is Mr. Muazzam Malik. Whoa! Mr. Muazzam Malik, right? So who is he? Mr. Muazzam Malik is better known as the British ambassador to Indonesia. And UniTalk was lucky, very lucky at the time, because we were invited to be there. At the time, the British Embassy, the branch office here in Bandung, invited us there. The located is at Pendopo Balai Kota Bandung. For they're actually doing anniversary of British Embassy Indonesia. And again, thanks because we're lucky. We were there. We had a nice interview with Mr. Muazzam Malik. And who actually is him? It's easy, right? You just search for on the internet, and searching for the name of British ambassador to Indonesia is Mr. Muazzam Malik. But to get the short information from me, he is actually, as I told you before, as I informed you before, that he is British ambassador to Indonesia, ASEAN and Timor Leste. He took up his post in October 2014. And don't you know that from 2010 to 2013, Muazzam was DFID Director for Western Asia and Stabilization. And earlier in his DFID career, Muazzam led work in the 2006 UK White Paper on International Development, making governance work for the poor between 2003 and 2005. Muazzam was principal private secretary to Baron Valerie Amos, and then the right hand Hillary Benn MP, Secretary of State for International Development. And prior to moving to Jakarta, Muazzam sat on the advisory board on the UK All-Party Parliamentary Group on Conflict, whereas was a member of the UN Secretary General's Advisory Group on the Central Emergency Revolving Fund. And also, he served as an OECD DAC peer reviewer for Sweden and a trustee of Goodweave, the UK, an NGO working to eradicate child labor from the South Asian rug industry. And you know, he is also very active as a consultant economist advising large UK corporate clients and the World Bank, amongst others. A researcher at the London School of Economics and the Overseas Development Institute. And don't you know that, as I told you before, thanks God, sure, UniTalk was invited to be there to have a nice interview. And at the time, Muazzam Malik was explaining about some programs from the UK that can be accessed by you young people here in Bandung and of course in Indonesia. He was explaining about the scholarship program. He was also explaining about the exchange students program from here in Indonesia to the UK, and also from the UK to here in Indonesia. Just stay tuned.
Hello, nice people of Bandung. Welcome to our UniTalk program. And today we have a very special guest coming to this place, what we call it's Pendopo Bandung, right?
Yeah, Pendopo Bandung.
We have already here Mr. Muazzam Malik. Sorry, Mr. Muazzam Malik. Hello, Pak.
Apa kabar?
Baik sekali, right?
Yeah.
Would you tell us more about actually the opportunity, especially for the youth in Bandung? Because you already mentioned it that relations between Bandung and the British Embassy are actually great.
Yeah.
And would you tell us more about it?
Sure. So, you know, I've been here for 2 years and I've seen that Indonesia is a country with enormous potential.
Right.
But the potential doesn't stop at the borders of Jakarta.
Sure.
Right?
Sure.
The potential is there across
that's
the country.
That's why you are here, right?
And it's why I've come to Bandung, because in Bandung what we see is we've got more than 70 universities, more than 200,000 students, talent pool
right.
that is bursting with energy, enthusiasm, innovation and potential.
Right.
So we're looking at how the UK can build partnerships and friendships and relationships in Bandung
right.
to help unleash that potential. And we've been working with Kang Emil for the last year or two. We've put a member of my team here in Bandung, and we're looking particularly at areas of creative industries. We're working with the universities, ITB, UNPAD, and others. We're looking at how we can create joint degree programs,
right.
how we can support the emergence of creative industries, and also how we can work with vocational training
right.
and really help unleash the potential of this amazing city.
Could we do it in the very near time, or we should wait until you're not here anymore, let's say?
So,
what do you think?
So things take time,
yeah.
but we've already seen some results from our collaboration.
Sure, right? Sure, sure.
So for example, UNPAD has signed and is beginning now to have joint degree programs
right.
with the University of Hull. They're going to start a joint PhD program
wow.
with King's College London, and they're also starting a joint medical degree with Queen
right.
Mary College. Now it means that students who are going to those universities are going to benefit not just from UNPAD, but from time in the UK and the opportunity to study and work in the UK. That's a real thing, right?
Right.
Second of all, last year we had our UK ID Arts Festival, UK Indonesia Arts Festival. The first time in our history that we've had an arts festival.
Right.
We launched it here in Bandung.
In Bandung.
We launched it here in Bandung
right.
at the sculpture park, Nuarte. Dengan para tokoh industri kreatif yang penting di Bandung.
Yeah.
So we got people together, we had a big festival there.
Mm-hmm.
And we had then a whole series of events here in Bandung.
Sure.
And then we're going to repeat the festival this year and again next year. And we're looking at how we can have residencies in Bandung and take some Bandung people to the UK and have
right.
residences in the UK, and then we can showcase their collaboration in the arts festival. Then in the summer, Kang Emil is going to open
Bulan Mei.
He is going to open a creative industry forum, a creative industry hub for Bandung.
Yeah.
It is modeled on Glasgow. Okay, it is modeled on Glasgow.
Mm-hmm.
So he took the inspiration from Glasgow to build this Bandung Creative Hub. So then we are looking at, okay, you've got the hub, you've taken the inspiration, how can we support you now? So
right.
tomorrow morning I'm talking to Tan Emil and doing detail from BCCA
yeah.
to talk about how we can do more in the creative industries, and we're looking at how we can make partnerships with the Scottish
yeah.
Creative industries. So I think, you know, I was talking to one of your talented people there about music earlier, there's so much we can do in music.
Right.
I think there's so much we can do together, but it's reality.
It's reality, right?
But plan, you know,
yeah.
Slowly but surely, and
yeah.
you build it up.
Right.
You know, lots of examples. ITB has a great collaboration with Goldsmiths University. And it's very interesting because what they have done. So Goldsmiths is a very famous British university focused on creative industries, okay? And what they did in Goldsmiths was in their arts faculty, they created a business program. Normally you want to study business, you go to the business faculty.
Yeah.
Right? At Goldsmiths, in their arts faculty, they created a business program so that the young artistic people could turn their talent into business.
Wow.
ITB have copied the idea. Right? So ITB are working with Goldsmiths, and we have some Goldsmiths lecturers who come and teach
right.
in the ITB program, and in the ITB CFA Arts program, they are similarly looking for building up a business program so that the talented young people of Bandung can turn their talent into business.
Sure. Right, so nice people don't wait. Okay, just grab the opportunity.
Let's go.
It's
you
thank
know
you so
my
much
motto. My motto
yeah,
is pekerja bersama, berhasil bersama.
Right, okay, and so it's leading us to the end of the interview. Thank you very much. Bye bye.
Terima kasih.
Waalaikumsalam.